South African President Cyril Ramaphosa said yesterday he considered Moscow a valued ally and friend during talks with Russian counterpart Vladimir Putin at the BRICS summit in Kazan. Leaders from 24 countries are expected to visit Russia for the three-day gathering as Putin seeks to build an alliance of nations aimed at challenging what he calls the West's hegemony.
We continue to see Russia as a valued ally, as a valued friend who supported us right from the beginning, from the days of our struggle against apartheid, right through to now.
Putin said Moscow's relations with South Africa was based on strategic partnership, equality and mutual respect. BRICS held its 2023 summit in Johannesburg, but Putin did not attend in person after the International Criminal Court, of which South Africa is a member, issued a warrant of his arrest. South Africa has obtained Take 3. South Africa has abstained from UN resolutions condemning Russia's February 2022 military offensive against Ukraine, but has called for an end to the conflict, spearheading an African peace mission to both countries last year. The UK yesterday began the early release of a second tranche of 1,000 prisoners, causing embarrassment for the government as convicts were seen being collected in luxury cars. A spokesman for Prime Minister Keir Starmer said he shared the public's anger at such scenes, but there was no choice not to act due to serious prison overcrowding. One man was picked up by a black Rolls-Royce by a group of men in matching hoodies outside a prison in Kent in southern England.
Today, the second tranche of emergency releases takes place, creating desperately needed space within our prisons. But this is not the long-term solution.
Another prisoner at the same prison who told reporters that he had been serving 7 years for kidnap and causing grievous bodily harm was collected in a convoy of a white Bentley and a black Mercedes G-Wagon. The scenes follow similar ones during the release of 1,700 prisoners in September when convicts were pictured spraying Prosecco around to celebrate their newfound freedom. The releases come as the government launches a review of sentencing to tackle the prison crisis. The review will consider options for tougher non-custodial punishments for some convicted criminals to ensure prison space is available to incarcerate dangerous offenders. Senegal is facing floods of its two rivers rarely seen since the 1950s. All the localities crossed by River Senegal are watered by chaotic unprecedented floods. On the entire right bank of the river, villages are submerged. Fields destroyed, livestock lost, and habitats completely submerged. In Arundu, Golmi, and Kongani, the river, which has always been the best friend of these water people, burst its bank to make all activity impossible and threaten the very existence of the populations. There are many victims who are demanding immediate aid from the state of Senegal, while we are struggling to see government or administrative authorities take responsibility and define an action. Over 55,000 people have been affected by the floods, according to figures released by the government.